In the normal circulation, the two circulations exist in what we call a series, where the blue blood, the deoxygenated blood, drains into the right ventricle, makes its way through the lung, then returns to the left side of the heart as oxygenated pink blood, and makes its way to the body.
In transposition, the pulmonary artery and the aorta are switched or transposed, so they come off the opposite pumping chamber. What that means is that the blue blood comes back to the right atrium, to the right ventricle, but now instead of going to the lungs, it goes back out to the body. So you have blue blood going in a circle, never picks up oxygen.
Oxygenated blood from the lungs then returns to the left side of the heart, comes from the left side of the heart out to the pulmonary artery, goes to the lungs in a separate circulation.
This creates what we call a parallel circulation, where blue blood continues to be ejected back to the body and pink blood begins to get ejected back to the lung, and the two circulations don't meet.
You cannot survive that situation, of course, unless there's some mixing somewhere in the heart. The mixing can occur at three different places. It can occur at the ductus arteriosus, which is the connection from the arteries to the lungs and the body that's always present at birth, but then typically closes because it's programmed to close after birth. Then there can be mixing between the two pumping chambers of the heart if you happen to have a hole there, called a ventricular septal defect. But the best mixing occurs at the upper chamber of the heart, called the atrial septum. And that can be open or not in these children. So how stable these babies are depends on how much mixing there is at those three levels.